Good afternoon, everyone. I am Kuldeep Jain from IIT DAVB. He is Shubham from NIT Nagpur and Ashmita from NIT Surat. In this project, we have developed a grid component that can be used to create grids easily and in a short period of time. Our objective also includes to make that grid component reusable and that can integrable with our X block. We also created a chess grid X block in which we used our component to create chess grids, and we further used it for the assessment. Now Ashmita will explain you about the functionalities of our grid component.
Yeah, so we use a JavaScript library to make the grid component. So this is the first function. This is to create a grid. So it takes us input your rows and columns to generate a grid of R plus C. Then there's fill character, which is for all characters, numeric, keyboard inputs, and fill figure, which fills it with the selected image, whichever you want, in the specific block of the grid. Fill color is there to fill the block with whichever color you want. And there's superscript for games like crossword puzzles. And these are some of the auxiliary functions to remove content from a single block. Reset is for resetting the entire grid to default. Enable and disable is for making a grid block read only. So basically, you know, you can't give any input. Like in crossword puzzle, a lot of blocks are just there. They don't have any functionalities. Then get data and set data for storing and retrieving whatever your state of grid is. So whatever you have set in the as your design for the grid board, you can store it in a JSON dictionary, and when you want to display it again, you use the set data to call it and regenerate the grid. Now Shubham will explain about the workflow.
So the workflow of our grid structure was basically like this. So basically there are two views, studio view and student view. So the studio view is nothing but the staff or the teacher will define the course structure, the rules of whatever the staff wants to teach. And after that he'll give a grid game, which we have taken it as chess. And he'll define the question and he'll define a solution to that question. The solution to the question will be just of one move. One move, why? Because our objective was to just make the library. So we did that, and then we showed that our library can be integrated with XBlock, and we were able to assess the student's solution as well when he makes one solution. So the student view is nothing but the student will log in into his account and he'll be able to look at all the course structure, everything, and then he'll be able to play that one move. And he'll be auto-graded by our X block. Now, Kuldeep will explain how the demonstration.
What is the answer you get after the student does something on your board and I submit? What is the answer?
So first, teacher has set one question in which one move is...
I don't care about question.
Okay, sir.
There's a board. I have done something to it. Okay. What? And I say submit. What data goes?
The data is collected in a JSON dictionary and that is transferred to our Python program inside. And where we compare the two dictionaries, that the dictionary consists of details about every block. At that block, what is the piece that is placed on that block?
Piece, the attribute of that
exactly
particular.
What I wanted to know.
Yeah. Yeah.
If it is piece, then you have only created X block, you have not created a grid.
We have created the grid and we have used that grid to make our chess.
Let's say teacher wants to...
Yeah, but you have written code, no?
Yeah, we have written code.
Right. Huh. So it is not a usable X block.
No, we...
X block is not reusable. But our grid library is reusable. Like if teacher wants to create a new code, like Sudoku.
Write, if I want to create a crossword,
yeah.
Okay, I have to write whole lot of code again.
No, sir, you don't have to. We after creating chess, then we also showed ma'am that in 2 hours, we were able to create another game which was Sudoku. We have created it and shown it to ma'am in 2 hours. We have used our library, we have made the Sudoku game, and then we have showed it that it works from end to end, like including the assessment.
No sir, those are those functions, na, create grid and all. So if you just call them, it will create it.
No, I'm just looking at the answer.
Which answer?
After the student gives an answer,
okay.
Hey, what is the input your XBlock gets?
It gets the whole information.
After getting the input, then I can access it,
nah? Yeah. So basically, every, like, the grid is created. Now it will go to every cell of the grid. Then every cell will have whatever attributes, say the color, the image on that cell block. Every attribute will be stored in the form of a dictionary, and it will be sent to the Python file, and it will be stored as a string. And then it will be and then again we convert into dictionary and we compare the strings.
which was given by the teacher and the
student. That is exactly what I am looking at. Okay. For every block in the grid, what is the information that goes back to your assessor?
That what value is that particular block has, what value is there, any image on that block, and what are the background image colors, and something whatever that user wants on it. That every information about the block is sent to our Python program.
So, and there are validations on the student side, so you can't change anything else, like except for what?
That I don't know. Okay, let's go to that. Let's not look at your demo, okay, because it is working. Okay. Now, for the block, okay, so isn't there a fixed set of attributes you are getting? A block will have some data, which is a string, okay. It's a string. It can have an image. So what are the various things that you
are showing? All the attributes. They are in a JavaScript.
Don't say all the attributes.
What are
there 10,000 attributes you are getting? No, is it user defined attributes is what I am looking at in software terms. Is it fixed set of attributes or is it variable set of attributes? Then only I know how programmable it is.
Sir, whatever is, we have made the...
Again, don't say whatever. Is it a list? Is it a finite list or an expanded
finite
list?
Finite.
So it's a fixed list.
Yeah. Yeah.
Correct. So now, so that is okay. So when I want to write the assessment software, I know for every block I am getting some 10 attributes.
Yes.
Alright, done. Very good. Now, what are the actions the grid presenter allows me to do?
It depends. It changes according to the game. No. Suppose it's Sudoku. Agar the Sudoku has already few numbers on the grid itself. Now, the student will not be able to change those numbers which the teacher sent, because he won't be able to change. He'll have to write numbers in the other things.
What?
In a Sudoku game, say.
No. Let's talk in terms of software, not Sudoku game.
Okay.
We are talking about software. So you are saying that my grid block, okay, will send back to the assessor a set of 10 attributes. I don't even care what they are.
Okay.
Okay. My next question is, if 10 attributes per grid block, okay, is being sent back to the server after pressing submit,
yes,
okay, then what operations can I do on the 10 attributes on the student side when I present the problem to him? It has got nothing to do with Sudoku. So what are you allowing? That is what I mean by framework. In chess, I can move the image from one block to from one place to another place. Okay. Correct?
Yeah.
So what are the set of commands that I am allowed to do? Is what I am saying. It's a move an image. I don't care whether it's chess or not.
Student is allowed to only fill the grid that type he wants. Like in chess, he can move the pieces. In Sudoku, he can fill the.
He cannot move any piece. As far as you are concerned, where is the question of piece? You just now said it's an image.
It's an image.
Correct. So it's not a piece.
Like in Sudoku, he has to fill the value.
Correct.
So there are two
What are the list of activities I'm allowed to do on the student side?
Okay.
And how do you control it? I'm not interested in writing software. Please. Okay.
Okay.
That you implemented involves writing software. I don't want to write software. If it is 10 attributes you are getting at the end of the students, this thing, okay, I should be allowed to modify those 10 attributes on the grid. One could be copy all 10 attributes from this block to this block, which is as good as an image.
So it depends on teacher what they want from student to modify in the grid. Whatever they want to modify in the grid, teacher will already set there.
Without writing Python code.
Python code is not required. While writing, Python like is only for checking the solution.
You'll have to call the functions, like if you want to.
I'm not going to call any function.
Sir,
I'm a teacher, I don't care.
Yeah, sir, if you suppose there is one block which the teacher wants to be read only, like he has set the number 3 and he wants that to be read only and he does not want the student to change that particular cell block.
Correct.
Then he'll make it read only.
Correct.
And suppose he wants, like, so.
Whatever is not read only.
In those blocks, the student will be able to write the numbers. Suppose Sudoku, so he'll be able to write those numbers.
Correct. So, how do I specify to your X block that the student is allowed to write a number between 1 and 9? That specification I should be able to do as a teacher. Show me that first. How I am, without knowing anything about Python, I can specify that the student is allowed to put the number 1 to 9 in the blocks which are writable.
Whether it is UI driven or whether
correct.
It is backend codable.
Okay.
Whether it is codable.
Sir, then it is codable.
It is codable only.
That is codable only.
So, sir, teacher will not create the X block. X block will be created by someone, then teacher will tell his requirement.
When I am doing Sudoku, I have to write Sudoku code. Who is going to write Sudoku code?
So again, that will also be done back end only, because teacher won't.
But that is what I'm asking you. Why you have designed the system, okay, so that I have to write code, teacher, as a teacher.
Teacher does not have to write the code. Teacher will tell his functionalities to whoever wants to create the X block.
I have to write code, no. But given whatever you have, can I create a crossword?
But sir, you have to write.
Can I create a crossword? I don't know.
So there are three things, sir. One is the developer, and then again, then no, a developer creates the.
Why you not jump that one phase? Okay, it's good. I'm not saying you have not done good job. If you have written something by which I can create a Sudoku puzzle, okay. Sudoku assessment, okay, not a person, Sudoku assessment, okay, in 2 hours, okay, you have done something, but you have not done the other phase. But a completely non-programmer should be able to specify a grid assessment block. Okay. Because your same Sudoku puzzle, okay, if I had given the flexibility to the teacher to specify that it is 9x9, okay, that none of the blocks are, all the blocks are writable, no, sorry, not all the blocks, that these are the blocks which are read only, in which case I put the number and these are the read only, okay, the rest of the blocks can take any input from 1 to 9. I don't have to spend 2 hours. So that is the functionality you should have implemented. Okay.
We did not implement.
What I am trying to say is, you should have gone from chess to I am doing a grid assessment block. A grid assessment block in terms of software specification is this. Okay, the teacher will, you have done one step, teacher can say this is read only. Okay, and if it is 10 assessment, then the teacher can say in each block, whether read only, write only, it doesn't matter. He will put an image, or he will put a text or an image, and anything else he can put, background color, foreground color, whatever it is. So I can do that. That is creating my this thing. Then I will have to say what actions I am allowing the student to do when he answers it. Okay. Then I am supposed to say this is my final answer. Final answer I give. Then my software is done. I can do any X board, no? Okay, next.
So initially we have to create an X block now for that our problem, and then only teacher
care.
Can use it.
I don't care. I will call that X block Avinash. And it's a Sudoku. What difference does it make?
So according to
will call something else and give the same Sudoku. What I'm saying, it's a grid X block. I'm just saying this particular assessment, I'm customizing it for my need. Okay, my need could be I give all in the Sudoku, I give one diagonal and that is my problem. That is my way of giving a problem. No, why have to write code for a grid type of assessment X block? Okay, it should be done without writing code. That I am convinced.
Okay.
From what? Because I asked you from the end. What are you sending to the assessment? If you are sending 10 parameters to the assessment, what the student can do with the 10 parameters? So all that is required, and that can be specified without writing any code.
So for assessment part, teacher is not required to any code. But he wants to specify detail how grade looks.
Are correct,
first time.
The fact that the teacher is not required to write any code for the assessment.
But sir, initially they have to create one X block now.
I have given you my views. Okay, you have implemented this, you can show it, but it's not necessary. I believe you. Okay.
But sir, teacher has to create one X block now, then only afterwards can be used to create such type of question.
So I create a chess based block. I say in the chess based X block. Okay, these are my images. I have to create the image to put in that stupid thing. Okay,
so
these are my images. I create the chess block by white black square. Okay, which I am supposed to do because it is my chess block. Then I say ki in this particular X block, any image can move from any image to any image. That's it.
So sir, we have.
This is the final image to check. That's it. So I don't look at anything.
So sir, we have implemented like this only. You can see an edit view. Teacher
that
can set the.
What is not acceptable is. That if you have already written a framework, the teacher has to write Python code to do Sudoku.
Oh,
has to write Python code to do crossword. Has to write Python code to do let's take this thing, snakes and ladders. Not acceptable to me.
So, but it is very little Python code.
No, not acceptable to me.
Not
acceptable to me.
the framework.
So, but teacher when log into his account, it will provide it a question gate where it can set whatever question they want.
I understand you are not one step further.
See,
okay.
There is no point in debating what you have done.
Correct.
You have presented. Fine. He has a different view, you have done different.
I'm not saying you are not done a good job. I am saying you have not done a complete job. You have done an excellent job. Let me tell you, if you are, whatever you have done, you are able to modify in 2 hours. Okay?
Yes,
is excellent. I am complimenting you on it. I am just saying it is for your learning. Okay? You have to take that extra step. Without me, everything should be
yes,
done.
Sir.
That is the highest level of a program. Without a programmer being present, the user can create 100 assessment blocks. Any board game you can do. That is what you have to aim for. You have done quite a bit. Okay, that you can write two hours a Sudoku X block is excellent. There is no doubt about that. Okay.
Yes, sir.
But for your learning, that is not enough. Enough is a package. You have not done a package. Okay.
Sir, a package
is something which any user can use. That is not a package. If it requires programming, it is not a package. It's customized.
So we have developed this component to be used by someone who is creating an X block.
Yes.
So for every time he wants.
What is your name?
Sir Kuldeep Jain.
You have to listen sometimes.
Yes.
We are saying that we have listened to you. Now you can stop debating and let's other to continue. Okay. Thanks.